Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through a worked example on how to select a compressor for a refrigeration system using the Danfoss CoolSelector 2 application. Coming up, defining the application details for a compressor, setting the compressor operating conditions, selecting a compressor, checking a compressor's performance through graphs and tables, view the compressor's operating envelope, find spare parts and additional information, generate a report for a compressor, and generate a bill of materials. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the CoolSelector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So, do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. Okay, let's get started. In this example, we want a compressor. So we'll go to the Compressor and Condensing Unit tab and then select Compressors. We now need to define the application details in order to find the most optimal compressor for our requirements. To do this, we must use the left-hand panel and complete it from top to bottom. First, we choose the application. In this example, we want a compressor for a medium temperature refrigeration application. So we unselect the other options. Next, we need to define which refrigerant we'll be using. In this example, we'll use R404A, so we select that from the drop-down options. Then we specify the power supply to the compressor. In our application, we'll be connecting to a 50 Hz, 3-phase, 415-volt power supply, so we select these from the options. Now we can choose which type of compressor we would like to use. For this example, we require a fixed-speed reciprocating compressor, so we unselect the other options. The next thing we need to do is to define the operating conditions. First, we choose between heating or cooling capacity type, and then we specify the required capacity. In this example, we require a compressor for a system with a 10 kilowatt cooling capacity. Then we need to set the evaporator conditions. Since R404A is a glide refrigerant, we need to choose the reference point for the evaporator and condenser temperatures. For the evaporator, we want to use the midpoint temperature, so we choose this option and then input our midpoint temperature value in the pop-up. CoolSelector 2 automatically calculates the dew point based on the input. We can also input the useful superheat in the evaporator and any additional superheat before the compressor. For the condenser, we'll use the dew point temperature. So we select that from the options and then input our temperature values as well as our subcooling in the condenser and any additional subcooling after the condenser. The selection table now lists the compressors which are most applicable to your system definitions and requirements. On the last column, we can find how closely each compressor matches the defined capacity. It's important to note that when a compressor's capacity is out of the minimum and maximum range, CoolSelector 2 shows a warning and changes the list entry text color to red. The range is set from 90% to 110% match by default, but you can change this in the preferences. The best matching compressor, according to capacity, will be highlighted in green, as you can see. This is only a suggestion though, and you should choose the best option based on the calculation and your understanding of the system. You can rearrange the table and also hide information which isn't relevant to you simply by right-clicking on the column titles and selecting Manage Columns. Additionally, you can also export the data shown within the table to Excel simply by right-clicking on the information and selecting Export to Excel, then saving the file to your computer. The performance of a compressor is a very important aspect when selecting a compressor for a refrigeration system. You can enlarge the graphs and tables by clicking on the Expand button located on the top right corner of the selection table. As you can see, that will hide the system definition options to display only the relevant compressor and performance details. You can easily bring the system definition options back by clicking on the Minimize button. Coming to the Performance section, we have different options such as cooling capacity, power consumption, and coefficient of performance. Each will display the relevant information for the selected compressor in a graph form. You also have the option, just above the graph, to display this as a table form. Again, you can export the table simply by right-clicking and selecting Export Data. If we now move over to the Envelope tab, a new graph will load plotting the compressor's design region and limitations for condensing temperature against evaporating temperature. The green dot represents the compressor's position within the operating envelope according to the operating conditions we defined earlier. We can see the green dot will move if we change the values for the evaporator or condenser temperatures. The envelope represents the limitations of the compressor. Selecting a different compressor from the list automatically updates the performance graphs as well as the envelope. Underneath the envelope, we have a legend which provides valuable information such as temperatures, cooling capacity, and power consumption. As we move our mouse on the screen, we can see the value changing, representing changes to the condensing and evaporating temperatures. If you choose a compressor and the green dot falls close to or onto the black line, the compressor may not run properly. If the compressor is operating outside of its design limitations, it could lead to compressor failure. A warning message will appear underneath the envelope explaining the issue with the operating conditions. If the green dot appears near, on, or outside the limitations, then you should reconsider your selection. You can reset your selection and start again by clicking on the reset button in the top left corner of the panel. If you had problems to select the compressor for your application, or if you have any questions about your selection, you're always welcome to contact Danfoss and discuss these further with one of our experts. More information can be found on the compressor by clicking on the information tab. For ordering your compressor, you need a code number, which you can choose here. Some compressors have multiple options. In this example, it's asking whether we would like an industrial pack which contains 6 compressors or just a single compressor. For this example, we'll choose the industrial pack. Once selected, we can find useful information for spare parts, dimensions, electrical specifications, mechanical connections, oil data, and some additional technical data. Under the spare parts tab, we can also select spares we require and add this to our report by clicking the Add to Report button. We can now generate a report for our project by clicking on the Reports tab located along the top of the window. This will display the operating conditions and our product selection along with any spare parts chosen. On the left-hand panel, we can add additional information to our project by clicking on the plus button and then selecting the options from the expanding menu. Once selected, simply hit the Update button. Additionally, we can add a project title, some comments, and include a name on the report using inputs under the project information on the left-hand panel. Again, just hit the Update button to add these to the report. If you need to go back to your selection page, just click the Selection tab from the top menu bar. You can come back to the report again by clicking the Report button. You can also generate a bill of materials for your project and provide this to your Danfoss supplier for a quotation. To do this, simply click on the Bill of Materials tab located along the top menu bar. Once you're happy with this, you can export this as an Excel or Word document using the icons above the on-screen report. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comments section below. You can also find links to more Cool Selector 2 tutorials in the video description below. Do check those out. Once again, thanks for watching.